Jam's Q93. Good morning, it's 7:22. 22 minutes after 7. Now, I'm CJ. Ladies and gentlemen, time for our morning message. Here's the Reverend Brother Pastor Deacon, Dr. Doug.
This is the Reverend Brother Pastor Deacon, Dr. Doug. Uh-huh. And those of you who were here last Sunday know that we witnessed the craziest thing this church has ever seen. Uh-huh. Since 68-year-old Mother Pettibone gave birth to a baby boy while shouting in the spirit. Uh-huh. However, the most amazing thing about that was the bat that flew out afterwards from the same spot. Uh-huh. But Brother Carly's ordeal topped that. Uh-huh. He was trying to restrain Brother Ike Tyson during the cast out demon night by giving him a butt to the head. Uh-huh. And by that I mean sitting on his face. Uh-huh. When Brother Tyson jumped up and bit him on both ears because he was full of a demon spirit. Uh-huh. Luckily, some of the deacons were armed with their gospel bats, and they beat the demon and most the hell out of him. You see, we stay armed in the spirit, as a natural fact. But when the spirit ain't handy, that's when we pull out our bats. Can I get an amen? Let me hear the congregation say, boom, shakalakalaka.
Boom, shakalakalaka. 7:23, 23 after 7. Good morning,
Q93. We open late till the midnight hour and the prices are tumbling down.
Available, call 1-800-366-3355 for blocking or billing questions.
Good morning, partly cloudy skies, 81 degrees at the lake, 74 in Slidell, and 77 in Kenner. I'm Monica Thier with a Q93 news update brought to you by Genuine Chevrolet, the cars more Americans trust. Don't expect to see any packages being delivered here in New Orleans or even around the country by the men and women in those brown short pants today. After weeks of negotiations, followed by the past several days of efforts to avoid a job stoppage, the Teamsters Union went on strike this morning against UPS, the nation's number one shipper. The strike will have an impact on those who move lots of packages on a daily basis. The Postal Service says that it can only take 4 packages per day from anyone while the UPS strike is going on. Meantime, most of the other major carriers like Federal Express are saying that they will not accept any new business accounts right now. Individual packages, however, are being accepted by FedEx and the other carriers during the UPS strike. Their attorneys say that they're not at all happy that 2 former New Orleans policemen were convicted of a lesser charge over the weekend. It took a criminal district court jury nearly 3.5 hours late Saturday night to convict Frank Oliver and William Moore of sexual battery. The men were originally charged with the aggravated rape of a 14-year-old runaway 2 years ago at a Tulane Avenue motel. Here's your morning Q-tip. The 14th annual Night Out Against Crime takes place tomorrow night in a number of neighborhoods. For more information, call 260-9393.
Thank you, Monica. We now have 5 to 10 cars in the longer lines at the Crescent City Connection. Inbound I-10 from the east to the high-rise Chef Highway, our point of delay. In through Kenner and Metairie, patchy slowing at the major intersections. And a breakdown I-10 inbound at Transcontinental. It's off to the side. Look out for it. At the Huey, slight slowing at the west traffic circle. Ferry boats are 2, 2, and 1, 2 at Shell Metro and Canal, 1 at Jackson Avenue, Gretna. An NOPD investigating an accident basin near Claiborne. And we have a cellular report of heavy traffic inbound I-10 at the Twin Spans near the hump.
Freeport-McMoRan is giving something back by funding New Orleans Outreach, a program that provides elective instructors, volunteer tutors, and teachers' aides to public schools. Make a difference. Make a phone call. 486-2887.
EJ Mays, Nothing But Jams, Q93.
New Orleans weather, chance of showers today 40%, hot with a high near 90. At 729, it's 79 in the CBD at Nothing But Jams. Q93, your station of a marathon of winning.
Ladies and gentlemen, for your inspiration, for your motivation, here's Monica's moment.
Every person on the planet is necessary and needed. There's so much to do. There's a dream for you to follow, a goal to set, a plan to make, a project to begin, an idea to act on, a possibility to explore, an opportunity to grab, a choice to make. There's plenty to do in this world.
It's 7:29. 29 after 7, that's Monica's moment.
Good morning, Nine Number Jams, Q93. What's up? This is the Fresh Prince, and y'all maxing and relaxing with who?
CJ Morgan.
Right here on Q93.
7:33. Kit Morgan, Q93.
remember that, just in case we ever face to face and make contact. The title held by me in the black suit, cause that's the men in me, that's the men in me.
Now the Jams, Q93, Ken Morgan is 736. 736 now, I'm CJ. Ladies and gentlemen, I understand the Reverend Brother Pastor Deacon Dr. Jug. Yeah, we had some technical difficulties on that. And we're going to kill the CD machine a little bit later on. So anyway, we're going to try and do it again. We're going to do him in a different CD player, okay? Here's the Reverend Brother Pastor Deacon Dr. Doug. I hope.
It's the Reverend Brother Pastor Deacon Dr. Doug. Uh-huh. And those of you who were here last Sunday know that we witnessed the craziest thing the church has ever seen since 68-year-old Mother Pettibone gave birth to a baby boy while shouting in the spirit. However, the most amazing thing about that was the bat that flew out afterwards from the same spot. But Brother Carly's ordeal topped that. He was trying to restrain Brother Ike Tyson during the cast out demon night by giving him a butt to the head. And by that I mean sitting on his face. When Brother Tyson jumped up and bit him on both ears, because it was full of a demon spirit. Luckily, some of the deacons were armed with their gospel bats, and they beat the demon and most the hell out of him. You see, we stay armed in the spirit, as a natural fact. But when the spirit ain't handy, that's when we pull out our bats. Can I get an amen?
Amen.
Let me hear the congregation say, boom, shakalaka-laka.
Boom, shakalaka, boom.
You're talking about the wicked.
They sent us a whack CD. It is not the CD player. It is a CD.
Ladies and gentlemen, to the company that produces the Reverend Brother Pastor Deacon Dr. Doug for us, this is what we have for you.
Come on, you guys are supposed to be professionals. You're making me look bad. 7:38 now, 7:38. Folks, we're trying to get you there safely. Let's check in with traffic. Here's E.J. Mays.
Welcome back, CJ.
Yeah, right.
IT inbound, we have a confirmed accident on the twin spans from Slidell. It's on the downside of the hump. It's an overturned vehicle and only the right shoulder is passable. Still 5-10 cars in the longer lines of the Crescent City Connection and past the madness in the east through the high-rise Chef Highway. Our point of delay from the west, patchy slowing at the major entrances. And be advised of a breakdown IT inbound at Transcontinental off to the side. On the Huey, still a slight slowing at the west traffic circle. Ferry boats to a Chalmette, to a canal, one at Jackson Avenue, Gretna. NOPD still on the scene of an accident. Basin near Claiborne.
New Orleans. Ooh, thank you. Another Bajansky night here. This has been a nutso day.
Really? Really? What's going on in there?
I don't know. It's like, okay, CJ, you're back. We're going to throw you every hurdle, every obstacle you could possibly dream of overcoming.
But just, you're clearing them with amazing accuracy.
Just to see if you could handle it.
And you can.
You know, my old Pastor Pat Rim Johnson. We're down there at King's Temple Missionary Baptist Church, Clarksdale, Mississippi. Always used to say that the Lord don't give you a testimony without first giving you a test.
Man, somebody
says, if you can't say amen,
say ouch.
There you go. So apparently that's what's happening in here this morning, but that's okay.
So you were rested and relaxed?
It's all right.
We'll show you.
Come back with a wonderful frame of mind.
Yes.
I can handle it.
Of course.
Thank you so very much. Anyway, we're talking about the Saints this morning. 260-9393. I didn't see any of the game. I was in Memphis, Tennessee.
That's right. And could have gone to the arena.
Saw none of, you see, that's what they say at Memphis.
Nothing?
None of the game.
None of the game.
None of the.
Okay.
None of the game. Okay.
All right.
I didn't even see a highlight. I just know that, and I'm listening to, what was it, 56 WHVQ, which is the official station of the Tennessee Oilers.
Oh,
that doesn't even sound right.
Right, right.
The Tennessee Oilers.
They don't even drill for oil in Tennessee.
And they weren't, you know, they never gave the score. It wasn't like, buddy D, every time buddy D goes to a break, buddy D gives the score.
That's what he's supposed to do.
You know, this is Hap's point after.
Oh, stop that.
And these people call up and go, hey, Hap, this how you Hap?
No, this is...
It's buddy, oh.
It's my show, but you named it after somebody else.
Oh, my heart.
You okay?
Oh, my heart. Anyway, I hope Buddy's not listening. Then you're trying to kick my butt.
That would be interesting. With
but
a
it, it made me appreciate, A, Memphis Radio, and B, the fact that, you know, we have a team that can't win, and we turn out and support it. They have a team that occasionally does win.
Yes, does win.
And only 22,000 people showed up for the game, and 20,000 of them were from New Orleans.
It's new. It's new for the folks in Memphis.
Well, being so new, you figure that not actually the people in Memphis are pissed off and have been at the NFL for years and years and years.
Yeah.
Because they've been, I remember 1973,
was my freshman year at Memphis State, they swore to God, if we filled up the Liberty Bowl Stadium for some really awful exhibition game, that we'd get a team.
An expansion team.
And here it is, 20-some god-awful years later, and they're still promising a team. A team finally comes to Tennessee, and it goes to Nashville. So now the people in Memphis are saying, wait a minute. Y'all gonna tease us with a team for 2 years till they build a stadium.
Right.
We've been begging for a team forever. Nashville say, we want a team, and gets one instantly, and we're supposed to fall in love with this. Uh-uh.
Well.
So people are upset, man. They're upset up there, and perhaps rightfully so.
Uh-huh. With the ticket sales.
It was really, really embarrassing.
Mm-hmm. Right. People were taking trains from New Orleans to go to Memphis.
Nobody showed up for this freaking game. Yeah.
Well.
It's my hometown, but I'm from New Orleans. Not people, where are you from? I'm from New Orleans.
That's right. You know what side your bread is buttered on.
You know, we got Da Coach.
That's right. Iron Mike Ditka.
And they went out and they played for Da Coach, apparently.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe because I didn't see it, okay? Show me the video so I can see the stinking game. I have no idea what went on.
Well, they won. There you go.
See how they
You want to see play-by-play.
267-9393, call number 9. I got tickets for Ringling Brothers Barnum and Bailey Circus for you and the kids. Call a 9. Call right now and win. Good morning. Q93. Our time 6 minutes now before 8. Don't be late. I'm CJ Superstar Morgan. It's the Ringling Brothers Barnum and Bailey Circus, the winning week. And I'm looking for caller number 9, AQ93. Hello.
Yes.
Yeah,
am I caller number 9?
Yeah, you're caller number 9. Wait a minute. Don't get so excited. First of all, you got to say those magic words to win.
I listen to Q93 longer.
Who's that? The ticket! Did I scare you there for a second?
Okay.
I didn't mean to if I did. Tina, it's the Ringling Brothers Barnum and Bailey Circus winning week. And you got four tickets to opening night, Q93 night, for Ringling Brothers Barnum and Bailey Circus. That's Thursday, August 21st at the Dome. You are in there, baby girl.
Oh,
congratulations, Tina.
Thank you.
Enjoy the circus and all the jugglers and all the clowns and all the aminominals, okay?
All right.
Once again, tell everybody, Stacey, you listen to longer?
I listen to Q93 longer.
Let me hear that scream again.
I listen longer to Q93.
I said, let me hear the scream again. Good Lord. Are you?
Good morning. Partly cloudy skies. 81 degrees at the lake. 78 at Audubon. I'm Monica Pierre with a Q93 news update. New Orleans prosecutors are pleased this morning, but the attorneys for those two former New Orleans policemen on trial for aggravated rape are not. Ex-officers Frank Oliver and William Moore, initially charged with aggravated rape of a 14-year-old runaway, were convicted late Saturday night of sexual battery of a teenager. They face up to 10 years in prison. Their sentencing is set for September 3rd. And lots of business people are scrambling this morning. While they were sleeping, some 185,000 members of the Teamsters Union went out on strike against UPS. The giant delivery service handles about 12 million parcels of documents every day. Here's your morning Q-tip. The 9th Annual Special Educators Conference takes place August 13th at the Radisson Hotel. For more information, call 260-9393.
Thank you, Monica. And we have confirmed an overturned vehicle, I-10 inbound on the twin spans from Flight L. It's on the downside of the hump. Only the right shoulder is passable there, and that's creating delays all the way back to Oak Harbor. If you're coming in from the west on I-10, our slowdowns are at Cleary, and past the commotion of the twin spans from the east to the high-rise, things get tight at Chef Highway. We have 5 to 10 cars and the longer lines at the Crescent City Connection. And on the QE slight slowing at the West Traffic Circle, all 5 ferry boats are in service.
Sign up for Pundit Del South Mobility. Count on it.
EJ Mays, nothing but jams, Q93.
New Orleans weather, a 40% chance of scattered showers today, high near 90. At 8 o'clock, it's 79 in the CBD. At nothing but jams, Q93, your station for a marathon of winning.
Me, I'm super fly.